Are you a practicing hypocrite or a passionate aspirant? Hello, and welcome back to the Manna to Live By. One day at a time. 5 minute devotionals. Today is July 11th. Today's reading is from Philippians, chapter 3 and verse 12. Not that I have already attained, or am already perfected. In yesterday's study, we saw that our conduct should correspond to our creed. But, in order to balance the subject, we must add two postscripts. First, we have to acknowledge that we will never fully and completely live out the truth of God, as long as we are in this world. After we have done our best, we still have to say that we are unprofitable servants. But, we must not use this fact to excuse failure or even mediocrity, as our obligation is to continually try to close the gap between our lips and our lives. The second consideration is this. The message is always greater than the messenger, no matter who he is. Andrew Murray said, "We who are the Lord's servants will sooner or later have to preach words which we ourselves are unable to fulfill." 35 years after he wrote the book Abide in Christ, he wrote, "I would like you to understand that a minister or a Christian author may often be led to say more than he has experienced." When he wrote Abide in Christ, he said, "I had not then experienced all that I wrote of, and I cannot say that I have experienced it all yet. The truth of God is superlative and sublime. It is so supernal that, as Guy King wrote, it causes one to fear, lest one should in any wise spoil it by touching it. But, must it go forever unheralded simply because we do not reach its loftiest summits? On the contrary, we will proclaim it even if in so doing, we condemn ourselves. To whatever extent we fail to experience it ourselves, we will make it the aspiration of our hearts." Once again, we emphasize that these considerations must never be used to excuse behavior that is unworthy of the Savior. But, they should keep us from unwarranted condemnation of a true man of God, just because his message sometimes leaps to heights which he himself has not attained. And it should not keep us ourselves from holding back the full counsels of God, even if we have not experienced them in full. God knows our hearts. He knows whether we are practicing hypocrites or passionate aspirants.
Let's pray. Lord, you know my heart, and you know whether I am a practicing hypocrite or a passionate aspirant. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, my strength and my Redeemer. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Are you a practicing hypocrite or a passionate aspirant?
Today's Manna, originally written by William MacDonald. Adapted and developed as Manna to Live By, 5 minute devotionals for YouTube by John Benjamin. For previous day's devotionals, please click the channel link given in the description box below. Thank you, and to God be the glory.